Let's start. Today is a great day, sunny day in Kyiv. Exploratory testing is my passion because I do exploratory testing since maybe 2012. It's a quite a lot period of time, almost 10 years. Exploratory testing I use in all of my projects, all of my products, and also when I became a QA consultant, I started to use this approach like a general, it's a basic of exploratory approach to be more QAs and testers. So let's start from introduction. I have a lot of different communities here in Ukraine. The QA blog is my first child from 2014. I did a lot of investigation of different articles, videos, and so on in quality assurance testing and management, test management. And all the library of good articles are here on Facebook, and everybody could look at it. Also, we have mostly I'm oriented on Ukrainian audience because I'm Ukrainian at first. But also, we have a lot of info in English. And you could also look into that QA blog at Facebook, and you could also learn something new for you because each article was pretty good filtered with me, and I did a lot of investigation of the best quality articles which describes something like with practical and not only with theoretical sites. Again, in 2017, I guess, yes, in 17, we, together with David Patsya, I hope you will also invite him on some next event, because he's one of the powerful QA engineer in Poland, and he also traveled all over the world with his presentation. He more quality automation engineer is much more better than me. But let's start with exploratory test. Also, a couple of words about my quality assurance consulting agency. We started since 2019 in January. Now it's almost 3 years we consult different products. It's mostly Ukrainian startups. But I also have one customer from US. It's like mostly not consulting, but it's mostly I'm a part of that company, Lucidworks. If you somebody here have heard about this company, it's a search engine. It is a great place where exploratory testing is using because it's a big data science project with ML, AI, and exploratory testing. In such cases, it's very beautiful to ensue. Okay, the main questions which we have is, can we completely replace scripting with exploratory testing? So first of all, you need to understand that exploratory testing is a bunch or bundle of approaches which use everything you know, everything you will know, and everything you known before. What does it mean? For example, if you have experience with test design techniques like boundary values or something like equivalent partitioning, you also could use this with the help of approach, because approach it's a way how people use their knowledges in the right time and in the right place. Okay, so scripting with exploratory is a good partner, and we need to use scripting and half exploratory testing together, because I don't like people who say, oh, can you do exploratory testing after everything is done, and can you do exploratory testing like a monkey job? It's a stupid decision to say like this, because people should be smart in quality assurance. We are not testers. We are quality assurance engineers. We prevent all the bugs. And my style of job activities, I never miss any critical and major bugs to the production, because I prevent them before I a bit shift left, and now all my developers work together and closely with me, and I will describe you how to make exploratory testing process transparent to your customers. It's the main question which always a pain for my student. For example, they have scripting testing, they do a lot of test cases, execution, checklist, and so on. But exploratory testing, nobody knows how to sell, how to sell this exploratory testing to your customers or your project manager. I will show you all approaches, and you can sell for your customers this approach as well. Let's start from other question. Let's continue. How to avoid duplication in testers' work during exploratory testing? For example, if me and Olga will start test some one project and one feature, we could make a lot of duplications in exploratory testing using so. But it's not works like that, because, for example, if you know exploratory testing, it's a bunch of experience, your experience, exactly your experience, and people think differently. Yes, all have seen that users should understand how to log into the system with the help of positive values. But I think that user could do some small actions which could destroy your system, destroy your login form. Okay, so we have quite different approaches, because she thinks positive, but I think in negative way. Okay, so duplication is a question of time mostly, but as I said, I will show you a lot of tools which is transparent. And if people know that Olga did this and this, they will not repeat it, because it's not chaotic process. It's a clearly planned and clearly understandable process. I will teach you today how to use exploratory testing in the right manner. I'm hearing some noises from Skype. Can somebody mute yourself? Testing approach. What is a testing approach? We know that it's like learning, test design, and execution are performed in parallel. What does it mean? For example, if you start doing your session with exploratory, you need to understand that in this current time, in this point, you need to learn how system works. You need to understand in your mind how to design the cases, and you need in the same time execute these cases and put your status like it's passed or failed. But probably mostly it's like a storytelling. I just writing, I'm going to enter some email into the login form, and I'm going to enter some password, like password 123 exclamation mark, and this is my like storytelling for you, and I'm clicking on submit button or login, and I'm expecting to be in my user profile cabinet, but it's just my suggestions and hypothesis that something will be there. I don't know, because I don't have any requirements according to your login form. I never been there in your site, but I'm exploratory tester. I need to investigate, understand in my mind how I will check this form with negative cases, how I will make this form with corner cases, cases which people already miss. Testers miss corner cases because they don't understand how to check corner cases, because they don't want to analyze a project. They don't want to study, and then they have never used competitors' work. If you want to be a cool quality assurance engineer, you need to compare your product with the product of your competitors. So if you have, for example, Spotify and YouTube Music, you need to compare. And you need to understand that if you compare, you learn. And if you learn, you know how to test. If you know how to test, you can test. Okay? This is the approach. Test cases are modified based on observations and learning of the product. What does it mean? For example, as I said before, I do some actions, login form, email, password. But in the same time, I'm trying to enter space between my exclamation mark, and this is the negative case, yes? And this is observations which I could expect that this systems, you could understand that this system, you could just make some idea that this system, if you enter space after your password, it will one moment it could cut this space and other moment it could decode it. Yeah. And this is the exploratory testing. You observe. And if you observe, you could update your test cases live. It means that you could update your cases because you understand and you learn how system works. We can use different test design techniques in exploratory testing. As I said before, all your knowledge is exploratory testing because exploratory testing is approach and all techniques, it's a part of approach. Session-based testing is used to make exploratory testing structured and focused. That is why I said that today, after you will finish this workshop, it's a short workshop, not a full workshop. It's a part, it's a demo version. So you will understand how to sell this exploratory testing to your customers. And if your customer will approve, you could take this workshop, full one-day workshop, and understand everything clearly and use these techniques. Practice these techniques and use in your daily activities on your job. Exploratory testing does not use scripts. Instead, it uses the tester's intuition, skills, and experience. I already said about it. What is not exploratory testing? It's not Turing only. Maybe somebody hearing about Whitaker, Catherine Clocky, they, and James Bach, they have their own exploratory testing tools. What does it mean, these tools? I will show you later. Exploratory testing is not after everything else is done testing. I don't like this. I don't like that people think that exploratory testing is a stupid testing. The exploratory testing is the one of the most powerful tool after your brain, because brain is the core of your quality assurance. It's a heart of your quality assurance, yes? And then exploratory testing, it's a tool with the help of your brain, and this tool, you could do a lot of powerful and beautiful things. Exploratory testing is not a quick check, okay? It's not like click on something and wait when system behave on this as you expect. Exploratory testing is not a not documented process. I will show you in the next couple of minutes how to use exploratory testing, and we will do some work together, maybe 5 minutes, to try exploratory testing with the session-based testing. Example of the learning stage. Before you start something, you need to understand that, for example, I will explain you example of my previous job activities. For example, I came to Thermo Fisher Scientific, yes, and they asked me to automate their tool, desktop tool, which is analyzing cancer cells. Okay, it's a quite unknown sphere for me was on that time. But what I did, what I did, I learned some documentation. Not, I learned a lot of books in this engineering. Genomous engineering. Yes, I read one book big. It's a 800 pages, and I finished three courses on Coursera, edX, and some other courses which describe me everything about genome. And only after I learned something, I become to understand how to work with cancer cells. Is it too hard and too complicated and too risky for people who can die because you miss some bug? And this is the most risky project is a healthcare and project with could cost people lives. Okay, studying and researching similar product already discussed, yes? How they work, what they do, what expectations they create. Questions: identify missing information as developers, business analysts, product owners, use help materials to supplement answers. Team research. So brainstorming is a good tool and powerful tool, and it also has their own rules. For example, brainstorming is a tool when nobody can interrupt you, nobody can lulling you, nobody can say that you are not correct, because brainstorming is a free discussion of something which is in your mind. Brainstorming is a powerful tool if you use it according to these rules which I said for you. If you will interrupt people, that man or woman can say that I will not continue because I had some idea in my mind and you interrupt me and now I forgot what I decided to tell. Okay, that is why it's a first rule: never interrupt people who are trying to brainstorm. Okay, the first rule. Session-based testing. This is our first practical activity. We have a charter. They include testing work. In fact, it's a blueprint for what should be tested in a particular session. All you know what is test plan, okay? And this is something like that. Test plan is a document which shows you what you should do and when, yes? Mostly test strategic say you how you can do it, how you could test it, and plan say when you can do it and with the help of which team you can do it and with the help of which tool you could do it, with the help of which consultant you could cover all the questions which we plan in some project. Time. Predefined continuous test scenarios. For example, now we will have 5 minutes only, but for sure you need to use at least 45 minutes to be concentrated on some job activities, yeah? Because 5 minutes is pretty small period of time and you will not even warm up, okay? Okay, because warm upping in all jobs, performance testing, security testing, functional testing, you need to warm up a system because system should be prepared for you and ready to test itself, okay? Because we need to prepare a system before testing. You need to warm up it. then report. Report includes notes and short report with a bug and what time was spent on activities. I will show you better in the example of charter. Charter is a document like a test plan. Short meeting between testers and test lead or manager to present results and discussion problems. It's like debrief session. Okay, this is an example of charter. Charter is like we have a main goal: analyze ordering and notifications of Amazon Web Shop. And we need to provide areas what should be covered and what should be tested there. It's like a small test cases, okay? And charter is like a test suite. What do you do? And test suite, sorry, not suite. Test suite, what you should do, and areas is how you should do it. Test environment, URL, amazon.com. Start, it's a date when people started. And better to provide here exact time and time zone. Because, for example, why did I ask you? Because now we all in different zones, okay? Rafael, for example, have 9 o'clock, okay, right now. And somebody has 4, and somebody has 2, okay? And when people provided who was, which tester was assigned to this charter and when did this session has begun, we will understand exactly when did was tested this part or that part, because you know deployments are shit, they could broke your tests if some deployment will start after you finish your testing, it's a shit work. You just did something which is not needed because you spend your time, and after that, some Oleg or Alexander commit something else and didn't provide any info in any chart, and you your testing activities was a piece of, you know. And that is why we need to track everything with this artifact. Artifact, it's a document which show you current activities, progress, and so on. Artifact is a beautiful thing if you know how to use it. And artifacts could be over. I mean, we could have over amount of artifacts, but better don't use everything. Use everything which would help you to save your time and to show your manager statistics and current status of your project activities, testing activities, quality assurance activities, better to say. For example, you provide here, like after this, you'll provide here 5 minutes duration. Testing notes. Open page with book you want to order. Verify that user can book in Kindle format. Verify that user can order book in PDF format. Okay? This is the checklist, and statuses will be user could book Kindle format book, yes, and user could book PDF format books. Okay? That is why you saw it's like a real scenario and storytelling manner. And when you have the storytelling manner, it's even beautiful to read it. Your PM or customer will satisfied with this report. Okay? This is not only a tool like a plan. Plan is always a thing which you need to follow. And this is, again, the same thing you are following, and you are walking right now exactly in these 5 minutes. You walk here, data files, link on screenshot, video, log files, or etc. Everything which will help your developer to fix quickly this project. Okay. Bugs is a link on all bugs. And one more thing, 1 second, I will put it here. It's a time on design and execution. Why do we need to track these percentages of work activity? I will show you. For example, when we spend some 1 hour, yeah, you need to do in the exploratory manner. Yeah? Like you need to think about what you want to cover. You need to think about how you want to cover. And exactly, you need to think about execution. How will you test it? Not only think. And again, this is a parallel job activities. You need to think and do exactly at the same time because it's a parallel activities. Why do you need to track it? Because when you provide some debrief results in debriefing session with a manager, you should show that 40% you are designed cases. You learn how system behave. You compare with competitors' applications. And you spend 60% on execution. So it's a good time for execution and designing. And even better when design will be mostly 55% and execution 45%. It's the best statistically approved and verified by me. Amount of percentage which you will need to spend on this. Because if you do a lot of thinking, you forgot to do execution. And the same piece of shit, if you do a lot of execution, you forgot to put results here. Sorry, if it's something rude words, please interrupt me and say that you should not say it. Okay, because it's a true life. Persona-based exploratory testing. So let's stop on this moment and let's try to communicate. Okay, I could stop sharing and we could start discussing some exploratory testing manner, do some activities to test something, okay? Let's go on some site, Olfa. Could you open, for example, bbc.com and share your screen?
Okay.
If you could. If not, I will.
I don't know if I have the possibility to share my screen.
Try. If not, I will.
Okay.
Okay, I see.
It's okay.
Yeah, so, bbc.com.
.com, okay.
Mm-hmm. For example, we have such site like this, yes? But let's do some exploratory testing. For example, we have 5 minutes and we want to check search, okay? Which cases do you prefer to check about, for example, COVID or happiness? What are you expecting to look into? Let's try to find something.
I think the first thing wanna check, it's the, for example, the CNIN.
Okay, let's try.
Okay, so I don't have an account, so I have to register.
Yeah, let's try. Let's continue.
Under, over. Okay, for example, I wanna have some bad inputs.
Okay.
Continue, so, okay, mm-hmm. Oops, that's great.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Okay. Great. He already gave me the country. I didn't fill anything in the country, but he kept the country. Okay. I will give my email.
Okay. Let's use something like your email just for testing purposes.
Okay. Register.
Yeah.
Sorry. That password is too short. It needs to be 8 characters or more.
This is a helpful message. Okay.
Yes.
8 characters or please do 8.
Okay. Okay. Show password.
Use suggestions. Okay. 8 or more characters, at least 1 letter, at least 1 number or symbol. Okay. Let's try to use. Okay.
At least 1 number or symbol.
Can you just click on register without symbol?
This?
Without symbol, without percent symbol.
Without
percent, yeah.
That password has been, okay, it's accepted.
Click on register. This password has been a part of data. What?
So continue.
We didn't use any symbol, okay? And it is this a bug? They asked us.
I think he accepted, but he said that it's not a very strange password.
Yeah, but you watched that there was like a suggestions to use, not maybe suggestions, maybe better to say rule.
Not required. It's suggestion not required.
But we didn't need to think. We do need to understand if it's required or not. Okay.
Yes, I didn't continue. Make the focus on this.
You need to make a screen. Better to use screenshotting for each step. Okay, it will provide a better results in your debrief report. So these all steps, screening will help you to show people how you think. Yeah, how your mind was. Like walking through cases, through scenarios. No, thanks.
So I have to continue.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm on my account now. I think I have to receive a message on my email.
I think so.
I have to check.
Let's try. Recheck, please.
Okay. I am not sharing my.
No problem. You could not share.
Okay, I have to check. Okay, I receive a mail from BBC Please,
Okay.
hello, please verify the email address used with BBC account by clicking in this button. If you need
okay, can
to
you click on on this like open in incognito mode, please?
Okay, I have to stop sharing and
yes,
I will share the whole screen. So this is the link. So thanks for verifying your email, and I have to continue to go to the website.
Continue, please. Okay, we're already signing in. Yes.
Yes. Signing. BBC account. This is my my account.
Okay, it's your account. And what is the name? Your account.
Yes, we don't fill my
okay.
Information.
Such as we started to test logging, yes, signing in. Can you sign out at and sign in with your new credentials? Okay.
Okay. You have seen it out. Sorry to see you go. So I have to sign in again. I already saved my information. So here
you don't need to use it. Just try to enter it again from scratch.
Register now?
Not register, sign in, but do not use this after filling. Use your, okay. Yeah, something like this. Redo all actions. Yeah, you could use that.
Okay, now I have to add
password.
I already forget it. I think it's
okay. Use this. Yes, this is it. 1, 2, 3.
Okay,
five.
And I have to.
Okay.
Okay, this is my account.
Okay, can you register with the same email address again, just to check if it's okay that you could not create any other account?
Okay.
But in the email address, please add one thing, +1 to your. To the end of your name, okay?
Okay, wait. I have to register. So he and over.
The same email, yes, sign in, but with a mail with the same name, but plus add +1. Yeah, okay. Day, month, year. Continue.
So and +1
to the end of your name before this yes
like that
plus yeah
so here we can so here it's in information they said that password need to include 8 or more character at least one letter
you see need to include. Can
yes.
you do a screenshot? Need to include at least one and at least one number
yes, so
or symbol. Number or. It's
yes.
correct. Yeah, because number or symbol. Okay, do the password. Again, enter some password and register. Because this is the same email which you used before, but with the help of +1, you will have new like account, but email will be the same. You will receive on the same email. Let's try.
Really?
Yeah.
And 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 tweets. Okay. Tunisia. Register. No. Continue.
What now?
Okay. So I have to check. I receive. What?
Okay, this is a bug. This is a bug because you can't use the same email address for different users. Because you could create from 1 to 10,000 with automatic script and you will kill BBC.com. Okay?
Yes, but it's, sorry, Roman, but it's not the same email.
Yeah, I know.
Plus one,
I know.
And I received the email. It's not. It's a security bug, I think.
Yes, it is.
Yeah,
it's great.
I'm really shocked for this. It's unbelievable.
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, isn't it?
So,
okay, let's go.
We have to check with BBC this
month. Yeah, yeah. Do not check. Just destroy them. Please use a script on Python or any other scripting language or even PowerShell and create that 10 billion Let's users see. With the same email, okay? And you will kill BBC in one day. Oh. And they will pay for you $1,000 and it's just a small fee. Okay, guys, who will first email BBC will receive $1,000. Because it's a bug bounty, okay?
Yes, it's already interesting.
It's a part of it. Yeah, of course. You could destroy their database, even cloud database, even all Amazon, which they use with the help of these combinations. Okay, yes, let's continue. Can you stop your sharing your screen? I will continue on slides.
Yes.
Great work, also.
Thank you for this experience. It's really amazing.
Yeah. Okay, I will continue the presentation. Okay, continue. Sorry. I just did. It's my previous slides. Okay, let's continue here. It's my yesterday workshop. Okay. Here, what do we have right now? This was our example, yes? We did everything. We spent not 5, maybe 7 minutes. We found one critical issue with exploratory testing. The number, what do we need to track, okay? Let's start from first line. The number of session completed and remaining. We was finished first session. 7 minutes, one critical bug, okay? Number of bugs, one critical, and one suggestions. Provide some more clarified instructions without or, because if you have or, you will give people to think what to enter, symbol or letter. Service, any service should solve people problem. They don't want to think. They want to be a stupid children. I think this because 5 years old children should quickly register to BBC without any doubts. Okay, that is why we need to provide for all the services in the world clear and understandable instructions without this a big amount of text. This is very helpful. The number of bugs reported. We reported one bug and one suggestions. Okay. Time spent on session 7, session stop, we just entered at the BBC, it's 1 minute, okay? We spent 10% of time to, for example, to go to BBC.com and to understand what do you want to test, okay? We decided to choose a scene-in functionality. Okay, 1 second. Time spent on testing, we spent 6 minutes exactly. Time spent on analyzing issue or problems. We analyzed this for 2 minutes and you were satisfied with the result. Features covered, we cover only scene in, but not fully, just a smoke check, okay? Again, go to the next approach. First approach will bring to our pocket 1 point. Persona-based testing, what does it mean? It's an approach which mostly use, and I just started to warming up you all of you today. And let's start and continue with the second approach. It's one of the powerful approach. All approaches is powerful, but this is the beginning of exploratory testing. Why do we need to use persona-based testing? Because persona-based testing, it's your audience. It's a auditorium which you sell your business idea, okay? Identify my multiple personas. You need to gather in your mind or on the letter, better on the letter. I will show you an example of a great persona-based testing report. You will have something like a report with different pictures of different personas with different ages, with different people, hobbies, and so on. Okay, describe them in age, job role, accessibility, if people have some disabilities. Yes, you could provide that. For example, your site could use people which has some problem with their health. Okay, and the geolocation, it's like a part where does people live and where does people was born, where did they born. Okay, and what we will bring with this info. It's like analyzing. When I'm starting my consulting activities, I went to my customer and asked them, for example, 20 or 50 questions. How do you use your system? Why do you use in this way? What is the main goal of your system? Do you have such or such processes? Do you have such or such activities? Do you use daily stand-ups? How long do you use it? Do all people use the stand-ups and speak something, or only your leader speak and other people nothing says? Okay, this is a good question to understand what is this product is about. Okay, what is the main goal of product? Yeah, and because of persona-based testing, we are analyzing the end user. We are advocates of user, as you all know, and we always defend rights of our end user, our customers, or our people who use our system. Okay, and the last thing, we need to create personas profiles. I will show you an example. 1 second. This is an example of persona-based testing. For example, what do I teach when I trying to give people some time on searching and investigation of the product with exploratory testing manner? We have a feature list. It's the main goal to study people how to think more critical and to use analytical skills and use your mind and brain for 100%. Okay, for example, we have some, it's my students, they always create some new startups for me. I just only need to pay for them. Search music by artist. So it's some application which we have a lot of features to use. To use user to find some artists in that application and some info about them. Search music by artist, search music by genres, looks, likes, music propositions. It's what I said about YouTube Music and Spotify. Look likes, it's a songs which you like, and the system should provide to you as more songs as you like, as you want, because sometimes you want to hear something new. And it's because the service, and you don't need to think about what do you want to hear. I think that in this time, this machine learning and AI should understand you, should see, look into your eyes with the help of camera, understand your current mood, and provide to you music which you wanted to listen at that time. This is the service. This is the product which my students trying to describe. And identification of persons, people with disabilities, children, teenagers, and businessmen. Okay, this is all like auditorium which will use our application. Describe persona, people with disabilities. It could be young people without work, programmers, or home sitters, okay? It could be old people's pensioners and businessmen. If we're talking about children from 3 to 7, this is a picture of children from 3 to 7, and they use this application. Mm-hmm. Children from 8 to 12, they we need to provide a picture of the people and how they use. They will be like on bicycle, with headphones, of course, and in one right hand they will have a phone, and in other hand they will have an Instagram, yeah? And under that Instagram is our application, because it could be a pop-up above, like we have with YouTube. Just play or do what you want, or choose your other song, okay? Teenagers, they are school-aged, or they are studying in some colleges, and businessmen, ladies before 30 and before 50 or before 70, gentlemen before 30, before 50 or before 70. This is a short info about your end user. What will it help us? Okay, when we have a basic feature list, yes, we could provide some more additional info on here and change something, like you think about, okay, if it's blind people, how will they use? So we will add voice control. Okay. One second. So we will add a voice controller, which will regulate like interaction with this application for blind people. They say, okay, artist up, can you please open the artist? Sorry, Siri, can you close yourself? Sorry, my Siri decided that I call to you, voice controller. Sorry, Siri, goodbye. Voice controller, so you could provide some info, some request to this application, even if you're blind, and you want to listen to Frank Sinatra, okay? And the song for today, happy birthday to you, okay? And this is cool. When you have this portrait of your audience, you will understand how they will use the application, and you will provide more money for your customers and more pleasure for your end users. This is a persona-based test. Please use it every time, everywhere, and don't forget to use it and share with your friends. We did a great job. It's a second approach, and it will help you to add one more feature, voice controller. Yeah, we already understand that this is like a this is an approach which would grow in you a business analyst inside. Okay, it's a great approach which will help you in future to be more creative, and it will help you to find cases, corner cases. This is the approach which will help you in future to bring more corner cases, which we would find a lot of bugs, like that which was with the email. Yes, it's a corner case. Nobody used it, but because of nobody know about this tips. Okay, it's tips and even trick. This is a trick which helps you to receive like to provide for people different addresses, and you could use this like give for different people this address for different groups, for example, group one, group two, and you could add plus group one, plus group two. And this will help you to understand that, is it the person from the first exploratory testing workshop coming to you with some question, or from second? It's a really cool feature of Google. Okay, let's go to other side. Let's be more polite and to breathe fresh air and think about theory. The six thinking hats in exploratory testing, what does it mean? For example, if you know about Edward de Bono and six thinking hats from his representation in his books, The Six Thinking Hats, you must know that all people in this life could use personas in their life. It doesn't mean that you need to use persona just to be good with your friends and bad with your, like, I don't know, with your parents, okay? because it's not the same like people who use a fake face, okay? It's another thing. Let's listen to it. Managerial blue hat is what is, it's like manager, yeah? He always want to control everything. What is the goal? What is the goal of this Arctis app which we was tested 3 minutes ago, okay? It was about great music and great service. You can control it with the help of search, with the help of voice search, with the help of even Siri, can you play music? And it will help you to use your voice. And this is the goal, to make people hands-free, okay? What is the subject? Subject, it's about service, it's about music. Why are we here? We here because we want to listen to different music in different time zones and with different mood, okay? And this application will learn your mind because of AI and will provide to you only that music which you want to hear. The next head is informational white. What are the facts? What are our resources? For example, what are the facts that this application will be used by all over the world people, okay? What is the fact that this application will be used by blind people? Why do we need to support these blind people? Because they also people the same as we, but they have disabilities and you need to think about it. Informational white is a head that need to provide the facts. Why do you need, why do you use, and why do we need to pay as a customers, okay? Emotional red, how do I feel about this project? What does my gut say? You know, American guys always say to me, I feel like my gut says it's a piece of bad project. Will not provide anymore this my rude words. This is a bad project and my gut says that it's no. So this is emotional red and you need to feel your project and you need to understand that if you use bad project, you need to say it for your project owner, for example, for your business analyst, for your developer. Even you need to say this for your end user that my project is a piece of bad product. You cannot use it because it's not user like, it's not usable. It's a bad UI, it's the worst UI because we don't have designer. We don't have UX expert. You don't need to use this application, but you could control it with the help of your voice. And this is an emotional. And if I will sell this product for you, I exactly will sold it out. All the application will be sold for €1. Yeah, because you can control with the help of your voice, with the help of Siri, with you could listen to the music which you like. Yes, it's not very great designed, well designed, but it's service. It's applicable for you. It takes your time, save your time for you and will provide to you emotional red. Yes, it's about emotions and we need to be happy all of our lives, okay? I think you should be the most happiest people after this workshop. This turning back, we are the danger areas. Where are the danger areas? What can go wrong? So it's about dangers. For example, we just now, right now, on the first hour practical session, we killed BBC. Business of all BBC was killed for 1 minute. You know, and this is a danger. And you need to ask yourself, you see, BBC, it's the most powerful news portal where at least 1 billion people use it for 1 hour, okay? And if 1 billion people will use this first case, the database of this will be killed because people will just start using this case and start kill BBC. Step by step. BBC need to provide and need to prevent these bugs, because they need some quality assurance expert like me, or like Olfa, or like Olga, or like somebody else in this room. Okay, you all came here. If you want to learn something new, I will teach you a lot. Optimistic yellow. Where are the opportunities? What are the benefits? So optimistic head always ask us, where are the opportunities? Why do I need to use your application? I said again, because it's simple to use. Yes, of course, because it provides you, like it saves you time. You don't need to search for Frank Sinatra. It will know about your birthday, and exactly in the first row, in the top five, you will see Frank Sinatra. Okay? Isn't it the best quality service? Isn't it the benefit for you? It's a benefit. And you need to be optimistic and to put the yellow hat on your head and to think about what could your product be for your user. How does your users will use your product? And how to become more flexible, more agile, and more suitable, and more UX experience for this product to be loved. This is the optimistic yellow. Green is a creative. It's one of my favorite because I'm a very creative person. Can we make this better? Can we incorporate new ideas? Of course we can. The question of a couple of minutes, okay? People always think that study testing is too hard and you need to spend 2 years to be senior. No, you could be a senior for 1 month, because only practice and only your passion, only your understanding in your mind that the goal of testing is not testing, but quality assurance, you will be a senior in that time. Because if you prevent all the bugs and if you do not miss any, you will be the best quality assurance in the world. Okay? Because the result is a quality, it's a good product without any incidents and bugs. And for example, I always do this example for people who don't understand what is a testing and exploratory tester. For example, we have me, who is quality assurance, and a tester, who is a tester. Yeah, my team always work with the preventing and to be a most the best team, like all stars team, which never release any bugs. We are trying to work like it's a teamwork, and never people found a critical bug after our team, because we prevent all the bugs. And manager came to me and asked, Roman, why didn't you find any bug for 1 year? I say, I prevent everything. How you prevent? Where is the result? I could say results is in here on the application. Nobody says that this is a piece of bad work. This is the most quality product you have ever seen. And if you think that tester which found 1,000 of bugs is better than me, than our team, I could say that this team is a piece of bad team. Mm-hmm. Because they missed 1,000 of bugs and even more, because if you find 1,000 of bugs, it's like effect of pesticides. Yes, bugs will be multiplying each other, because bugs is alive. They do sex, they do another bugs, because regression, because of stupidity of team members, because of lack of communication, because of misunderstanding of requirements, because of product owner didn't have expertise in the domain, and because. All things you could cover with the help of your mind and this great thinking health approach. Risk-based testing. What does this risk-based testing? You know, Rex Black is oriented on risks. Yes, he's a great person. He has a lot of experience in testing, and he could understand and predict some risk and cover them. We also could do it, one second, with a boundary value analysis, when we know about all the boundaries in your application, we understand that this science, which developers always miss, it could cause a lot of problems. And I don't know, I don't even know any person who never find a bug on boundary values. One thing, people which I spoken didn't know about this, yes, technique, or they even didn't try to use it, okay? Because each people who are working at least 1 year on some project, always we have a problem on boundaries. Boundary value analysis guides you in the details of testing. You should understand, even if you have a lot of different boundaries and different, for example, thresholds, and each threshold is a complicated mechanism of calculating, you need to understand that if you analyze and provide some info on your piece of letter, you will know how to test it, yes? How, which technique to use and how many time you need for testing, okay? Equivalent class partitioning, we always need to understand that each type of data could have their own types, okay? If it's a mail, we have a type, different type of email. Today, all of you learn one more email type, yes, this plus one. But tomorrow you will learn that we will have new format of email with the Russian words, okay? It is a Kyrillic words. But because you never tried it before, but soon you will have possibility to use not only Latinic, but also another symbols like, I don't know. It's just a future which help us to use anything, even hieroglyphs in the email, just for Chinese people to use their native hieroglyphs to provide only one hieroglyph, add and domain, and that's all. It will help them to represent themselves, okay? State transition is a great technique. I will show you a small presentation about how it works and how to use it. Risk mitigation, we need to find the problems before they appear, okay? We need to prevent the problems, notice pattern of bugs. For example, what do I mean when I said about this? For example, you have Alexei who always worked with, for example, search on your site. And he always missed the same bug. The PM or product owner said for him always, can you use not like approach, but use match approach, that all the words, if we enter I want to find, I need to see results only with I want to find, and not with I, not with a, not with two. I want to receive a perfect match response, okay? And he always did the same like bug on all of us, all of our projects, okay? This is the preventing. When you know about Alexei's problem, you could say, listen to me, can you please give Alexei to use don't touch search, okay? Because he always do the same, okay? This is a preventing and risk mitigation from the side of exploratory testing view and quality assurance process, okay? Expect problems, be ready to respond quickly. I like to work with people which honor our times, okay? If we have some bug, don't try to log it into the Jira, okay? Try to ask developer how quickly he could fix it, okay? If he will answer or she will answer that it will take 3 minutes or 10 or 1 hour, please put them out that this is a bug and it will be fixed in 1 hour. Do not create Jira, because it's like a divorce. Yeah, you have a great conversation with that guy, and now you create a bug on it, and he say, why? I could fix it for 1 minute. Why did you do this? You just blame my statistics. I'm the best expert senior. Why did you create this bug? You could say, it's only just to not miss it. It's a great answer. But sometimes better to and faster to fix a bug than to log it to the Jira. Okay? You need to understand this. And our 1 minute of our time costs, for example, 10 cents. But this 1 minute, when I do optimization of products, I save for each my client more than $15,000 per month because of this stupid process which testers and developers do. They don't understand that the 1 minute of time for each team is a 20 minutes. 10 minutes of 20 people is a 200 minutes. And even 3 hours of 20 people is a 60 hours. For 60 hours, I could teach you everything I know, okay? And you could be a great senior professional. But you will pay for me for this 60 hours, $200 per hour, for example, yes? You will pay, I don't know how much is that. It's, I never did this before. But it like $12,000 you will pay for 60 hours, and you will receive what? You will receive a seniority level, okay? From junior to senior for 60 hours. Because I like teach people. I'm teaching them 10 times a day and from 2002, okay? And this is a great that you have 20 years of teaching experience, and you could provide info very beautiful manner. Okay, I'm watching on the time, and I can say that we even could finish earlier. Don't worry. Okay, pair-based exploratory testing. We will not have any practical experience on this, but I could say exactly, and it's a great statistic that after pair-based exploratory testing, when you provide it to your projects, you will say not even save. You will find on 30% more bugs. It's a statistic. 100 people find on my courses more bugs on 30% they found by doing their job alone, okay? What is this pair-based exploratory testing? For example, we have two different options. We have traditional pairing, operator and observer. What does operator do? He do something on the side, on BBC. You was an operator, yes? And why I was in the previous case, a navigator, okay? I said you what you should do also. But now, when we will came to the BBC, you will do some action like operator, and I only will be staying behind you and watching. I will put some notes to my blog note, to my notes, and after that, I can ask you, why did you do these use cases? And you can answer, because I can, because I know only how to do this in this direction, in this way. And I can ask you, why didn't you try this? And you can answer, because I never worked with this. Okay, let's switch. I will be an operator, which was behind you, and you will be a navigator. You will say to me, Roman, can you open BBC? Can you enter to the search COVID-19 without, for example, any signs? And the results will be, of course, because it's a like search. But you could also tell me, Roman, can you put 20 spaces and then COVID and then click enter? I say, why? You say, I want to check. And I would say, what would you want to check? And you will answer, I would want you to understand me and would want to, you to say that this is a corner case. And 20 spaces is stupid. One space, two space, three space, okay. Because we could cut only one space, only one, because the code says that the last space should be cut. But if you have two or three, you will check that if two, only one cut it and one no, you will understand that this is work only with the last sign, okay? And this is knowledge sharing. I'm sharing knowledge with you, and you understand and keep into your save into your knowledge base, okay? And after this communication, pair base is the most powerful tool in each team. We need to bring this technique in each project, because in pair you bring a lot of things. You need to be ready to test with some ideas. You came to somebody and say, Onfa, could we test search? I know search well, okay? And you don't know because you work only with signing form. Mm-hmm. A part of the product you don't know well. I want to ask you to help me with the signing form, and I want to learn something new, okay? And it will be good for knowledge sharing and to avoid bust factor when somebody was died because of COVID. And it could be now, it could be because it's a world and it is a situation in the world. That is why we need to do this to share your knowledge, because tomorrow, even me don't know, will I be alive tomorrow, okay? But I could leave after me this workshop, and you will provide this workshop hundreds years in future, and I will do my mission exactly as I wanted, okay? This is the knowledge sharing which we do right now, and this is the pair-based testing. We do in pair some learning activities, some studying. You could teach somebody to automate. You could learn from somebody how to automate correctly. You could find people for pairing. You could find somebody who understands something better than you. Or again, you could find one junior who want to be a senior in some time, and you could help him to become a better seniority level specialist. Someone you enjoy working with. It's a great example when, as I always say, Onfa, I want to work with you because I like your style of testing, yes? And you sitting like in the corner and always bring a lot of bugs to our Jira. Mm-hmm. And you say, oh, Roman, it's pleasure to hear, okay? And I say, okay, Onfa, can you show me how you test CNN form? And I want to learn this and use your approaches in my testing activities. And you say, okay, today I will show you, and tomorrow you will help me. Okay, this is a deal, win-win. you say, okay, I will show you how, and from tomorrow and for 10 days, I will go to Dominicana. Okay, and you will teach you, and you could start testing as me. Okay, this is the knowledge sharing, and this is a bus factor avoiding. Another, we could approach people. Come prepared, figure out the details of your working activities, and do it in retrospect. What did we do with you, Onfa? We did testing for CNN for BBC. What did we do well? We did find a great bug. It's a critical bug, even blocker for some reason. He could block database if you will use scripting, okay? And what could we do better? We could speak more, we could spend more time with you, and we could understand that together, only together, we will cover everything. Mm-hmm. What is the benefit of pair testing? It helps the tester to focus on the tasks at the hand. It means that you do exploratory testing, it's parallel. Analyzing, investigating, designing of cases in your mind, and again, in the same time, you are testing it. It's not the same, like you have a 2-week sprint, and on the Monday, you did some 100 test cases, and on the next Monday, you start testing it and do quality control, not test, even not testing it, quality control, okay? You are not care about what did you write there. And from that time, everything was changed in documentation. And you also didn't care. And you start testing, and you start raising 100 bugs because everything was changed. And you should know about that, yes? But nobody said you that something was changed. And you believe only your experience. You did write cases for 3 days, 100 cases. You spent 3 days, 24 hours you spent on these cases, and nobody, you listen to me, nobody says that something was changed. And now you do quality control. Imagine if you had exploratory testing knowledges in your head and you use it instead of quality control activities. And you know, my scheduler for all testing activities, I'm gathering all the info. I use acceptance criteria, write positive and negative cases like a checklist. I do mind mapping, show everything in one place. I'm analyzing, go to developers, speak with them, business analysts, architects, and I communicate. After that, I do exploratory testing. After that, I do checking from that steps, which I did for checklist, yes? And I spent on this less time than 3 days, yes? And I found much more bigger amount of bugs than you, because this is my approach, which I developed for myself. It's because I know myself. I don't know what do you feel when you do your job. Maybe you don't like your job. You just only like money, okay? You don't want to think about something. You just only want to buy a new dress, for example, okay? That is why when we will work together, you will be in a beautiful dress and I will be with a good smile, okay? Because we will make together a great walk and we will found a great box. It encourages a mutual trust and respect among partners. Okay, Olfa, do you believe me after this first session? At least for 10%.
I believe.
Okay, we have a mutual trust. Brainstorming between pair testers usually lead to more constructive ideas. We did brainstorm a little bit and found new bug. Avoid tunnel vision. So you now understand that you could use this approach in your experience, and this experience will be a couple better than you had before. There is a lesser chance of other interrupting them. For example, if we have some conversation, nobody can come and nobody can say that, Olfa, can you go with me to drink some tea? No, it's not ethic. Yeah, we work together and we speak together. Don't interrupt us, please. Okay, about tours. We have 5 minutes, yes, as I understand, because we started with some problems, yes?
Yes, it's okay.
Okay, exploratory testing tours. The money tour, what does exploratory testing tours mean? In general, exploratory testing tours, it's like visualization of test suites. What does test suites mean? Test suites is a bundle of use cases, which is covered with some documentation, checklist or test cases, okay? And visualization, it's something beautiful, which could be placed on some piece of paper and everybody can look into that. For example, for now, we have a great product, it's a mirror, yeah? In mirror, you could look into that mind map and to see how beautiful is your project in pieces. Small pieces, you could do decomposition of all of your product, all of your objects in your product, and understand which component is work with other, okay? You will see dependency between different components on behind you, on your wall, on the wall. And the money tour, for example, it's an example of visualization. Okay, why does a customer pay money for your product? So you need to think about the most paid features. Paid, not money paid, but what does your users use mostly? Okay, this is the money tour. You, if you look into BBC, user always use what? Search. User always use what? The main homepage to read 10 or 12 articles when they had some breakfast. Yes? And this is the all main activities. And this is the money tour. And if you do the money tour during your session, you will find some bugs during your breakfast. The all-nighter tour. You already could have such a situation when some bugs only happen if the software has been running for a long time. For example, your software have like a payment system, okay? And you would find a way how to buy a ticket on the conference, which will be on the Cyprus on the next week, okay? You just started to look into this conference, Cyprus IT Forum, and you just find, for example, tickets, different tickets. Tickets with networking, tickets without networking, tickets with food. And you just started to look into this and started to put radio buttons in front of that or checkboxes in front of the tickets which you want to buy. Yes, you open the form. You just started to enter in your card. You just started to enter in CVV. And CVV is correct. But you have a dynamic CVV. It uses only once. And in each 10 minutes, it's updated, for example, yes? But you just went with your sisters or brothers to the disco. You came back on the morning and you click buy. What will happen? How do you think?
I think the session is terminated. It's over.
Yes, it is, it will. And what will be if terminated session will be appeared? What do you expect from this case to see? What do you expect? What do you expect?
I think it's about an error page or something not found, or we have to redo the command and.
So, for example, yeah, it's hypothetically it's right.
The expected one.
Yeah, you expect this, yes. You expect that your payment system will answer that, sorry, session expired. Browser session was expired and you couldn't buy with your entered data. Okay, something like that. Mm-hmm. But nobody expects that you will go on disco with your sisters, okay? Your sis ask you because some of your sis has had a birthday yesterday, yes? But today you have a birthday because you bought a ticket for free. The system, previously, you put all that checkboxes, yeah? And in general, when session is died, you need to put into the form all the data, okay? But now on the backend, you put the data, okay? And you bought the tickets for free because payment system doesn't know about the case that you will go to this disco with to celebrate the birthday of your sister.
There is no a token with a period. No.
They have, but backend and frontend did not communicate
explain,
with them.
Okay, explain.
They didn't expect. And from frontend you send, but backend is annulated all your data. And you will receive payment $0 and pay. Okay, and you will receive a ticket for free. This is a bug.
Yes,
this was my case, which I was used with the help of this tool. Okay, is it good case? Okay. It's a real example.
Yeah, it's a critical one.
It's a critical one. Yeah, because all-nighter tour, nobody use it. Somebody use, but no, I mean, not rare, okay? Not often, sorry. The saboteur tool undermines the software in a way possible, in any way. for example, saboteur always want to broke your everything you do, okay? And if you use saboteur tool, you would kill BBC, okay? This is saboteur. We did some sabotaging of BBC. Intellectual tool is used to ask the software really hard questions. For example, smart and clever question. How BBC will find me something which I want to read? For example, I want to read an article about, I don't know, Roger Federer and about the plan when he will play in the next season, okay? This is my question. I would want to put this info into the search, and I would want to expect that this BBC will show me each article where was like info about the next season games of Roger Federer, okay? But it's not will work like that. You will broke. Can you try this BBC behind my screen? I will continue and you will say me, what did BBC propose for you? Garbage collector tool. For example, sanitation works go street by street, house by house. They stay only a few moments, but they crisscross the neighborhood in a methodical manner. For example, sanitations always use a well-planned scheduler that first house on the street will be from on the left side, second will be on the right. Not like that, like first, second, and they have some routes, yes? And these routes always use the same roads, and they can't use another ways how to take garbage from these neighbors. And one day, the second house was sold, and nobody called to this sanitation, and nobody says that we will not pay money for you, you could stop use our garbage, okay? We will not pay for you for that. Okay, but they have their schedule and nobody calls them, and they use their route. And how to use this on the real example case? For example, you have some feature, and this feature works accordingly to some routes, use cases, okay? And on the back end, everything stays the same, but on the front end, somebody decided to remove a piece of product. For example, they remove search, okay? And before you did automation with API, and your API, for example, from the front part, you couldn't do any search activities more, but on the back end, you could. But architecture of your project was changed a bit. And when you send API, because backend was not changed, why does we need to change? User will not provide any data because he will not see search. But we have API endpoint and we could send some message. And in this case, the garbage collector tool will show us that your system will be broken because of this stupidity that something was changed on the backend or on the frontend and nothing was changed on the backend, okay? And this will be the case which will find you 500 error. Remember this key, please. Okay, I will not tell you everything about these tools. You could read the book, Exploratory Testing from Whitaker, Exploratory Testing Tools. Planning in exploratory testing. Please do use this mind mapping to do such great maps. What did you have there? You have there a lot of Jira objects, and they use arrows to show that issue use some project field, which use project from here, from the bottom side, okay? And this will help you to investigate a project and to visualize your knowledge in one place in front of your working place, okay? Reports in exploratory testing, we already discussed. And few things to keep in mind when doing exploratory testing. Your mission should be defined. Be sure to make notes of what you are checking and make reports so that you can understand what work you are doing. For example, We already have this charter, and please use that example. I will provide to you all the docs which are used, have used in this workshop, and you could try to work with that on your project. It will be my little present in your community.
Yes,
learn, observe, and then come up with new test cases. And if you have some any other question, please ask. And here is some piece of reading materials. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Roman. Thank you. It's really, you have covered all the aspects and points of the topic. I don't know if we have some the time to ask some questions. I have, I think, one or two. It's about, I think that for exploratory testing as well as for other types of tests, if you used only one type, it's for example only one, only exploratory testing, we may not cover all the requirements, then some points may be overlooked. So the question is, if it's possible to combine several types of types of tests to have more advantages on the coverage and security of our system?
Yeah, of course. It's the answer is covered under the approach, like more from managerial part. For example, if you want to do a strategic of your testing, you could do what? You could create a charter before you, can you mute yourself? Before you start your testing activities. I hear it myself, it's not very good. Okay, I will be a little bit. If you would prepare something like a strategic for these activities, you could provide some charters with ideas. What should you cover during your exploratory testing? Yes, and if you would be prepared, if you will be prepared for your future sprint, yes, you could use these charters as a charter. Charter is like a navigator. You could go one by one with this charter and cover security, performance, each cases which you would want to cover during your testing activities. And you even sometimes don't need to use even scripts, because scripts will be inside exploratory testing, as we saw in my example of charter. Okay, Olya, you looks very nice.
Yes, thank you. So I have another question. I don't know if someone else wanna have or wanna interact. Then I have a question. It's about when we could proceed to the exploratory testing. It's only on the system phase level, or we can use it on every level on our basic or daily work or on our life cycle of the software?
Yeah, I could answer easily. Use exploratory testing in your life. That's the answer on the question.
Everywhere, so.
Everywhere. I live with exploratory approach in my life. Okay? And better to use this as earlier as you can. Okay? Please do it right now.
Okay. I have another question. It's, in fact, the relevance of the tests and results depends on the experience of the testers. That's it. We don't have the same results with the junior or seniors, but we talk about pair testing also. So it's true.
Yeah, it's true. It's a great question. Thank you for who was like initiator. Seniority is quite a great metric of like team growth, and if you had a senior level and somebody has a junior or middle level in your team, please do more pair testing to be in the same seniority level altogether. And of course, if you're a junior one, you could not find something corner cases. But even if you use the same charter for after the junior and use the same goals and areas which you would want to cover, please do. It's like, as I said, it's not duplication, it's another experience. That is why the answer on your question is, doesn't matter who you are. Exploratory testing is the most priority thing for quality assurance engineer, not for tester, for quality assurance engineer.
Yes, exactly. So thank you, Roman, for this presentation. It's really, really very interesting.
Thank you for inviting me. I'm very glad.
Thank you.